Welcome to the shooting show, brought to you this week from Nuremberg. It's IWA 2017. We'll give you all the highlights of the show later. But first, it's Geoff Garrod tackling the Tauben down in Essex.
Again today, another pigeon shooting day. As you can see from the weather, not the best conditions. It's quite overcast, bit of mist, but there is a wind which will help. But today we're joined by Alan Tyte, and the reason Alan Tyte is with us today is there's a bit of a story to this guy, so just bear with me. A chap named Sean Whiters was asked to go and help a pal of his in distress because his car had had a puncture. He duly turned up to help his mate out late at night and was promptly run into the back of by a drunk driver. The end result was that Sean Whiters had to have both legs amputated to save his life. And since that horrible incident, there's been one or two charity dues gone to raise money for the guy, because he was a very sporting guy, played a lot of football. He was playing for Newmarket Town Football Club, and obviously that's not going to happen now, so a lot of money's being raised. The reason Alan's with us today, it's because a friend of mine, well, and Alan's, called David Sheldrake, run a clay shoot, 100 bird clay shoot, and also put an auction on the side of it. And he asked me for a donation, so I donated a day's pigeon shooting. This is the reason why Alan's here with us today. He very kindly paid a considerable sum for it, so we're here today to try and make his day a good one. But where we are, there's a piece of maize there, and then there's trees in the background there. We're going to go up there and we're going to be over by the trees, because with the conditions today, if they're not sure about coming on the maize, they will go and sit in the trees, and we're hopefully going to decoy them on the ground in front of the trees. Come up through here, so obviously land this bit here, so I'll sort of put a couple here and dot out here and put a couple across the front of the line, so all about the yard. They come along here, mate, and they look for anything that's sitting here and then bush straight in. So with the wind sort of here, chances are I'm going to slide up the motorway. Push. Right. Get yourself ready. Yeah, Alice, come up side here. Here, just come up side of the motorway. Front. Let it come in now. Well, I've been here now for about 20 minutes, half an hour. The hide's set. It's good hide, they're not seeing us in here. We've had a few pigeons come in, we've probably shot there about 10 or a dozen. But the weather's closing. I didn't think it was going to be this bad. But it's very grey and misty. But the pigeons are coming over, still flighting. And we're getting one or two to come to the decoys close enough now so we can start having a shot at them. So, you know, just need the traffic to keep going, and then hopefully, not that traffic, but the pigeon traffic to get going. So hopefully we can build the day up. Yeah, what's happening, because we're getting sort of like through the day now, we're still getting big groups coming in, but what seems to be happening is that first pigeon that comes in out of the group, shooting it, single shot, killing it, and then we seem to be getting a few shots from the rest of the group, seem to be coming round and coming in again, so it's not as if you're getting up and going bang, bang, bang on the big group, which will totally disperse them. By just having that one single shot today with the noise, a bit of background noise, it seems to be killing the shot noise, and we're getting a bit of shooting afterwards. So whether that's a little sort of thing for the future, it's worth thinking about. But today it seems to be working. Tried to be a bit clever there and killed two with the first shot. Got one and then missed the second one.
Loads up the buffers. Yeah. Yeah.
as you know, I've been shooting the Eley Pigeon Select cartridge, but with my help we developed a year and a half, nearly 2 years ago now. It's a 30 gram cartridge, but for those boys out there that feel they just need a little bit more, Eley have produced a Pigeon HV, which is a 6-shot, 32 gram. And I sent a few up here, and we're going to give them a go, see what we feel of them. Shot.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I like them green ones. Let's certainly pack them up.
Some decoying, is it? Yes. Yeah, coming in from the right, from the right, from the right. This is the moment we've all been waiting for.
Oh, okay. That's just good.
That's my bit. Alan's bit. Cameraman's bit.
Shot.
Shot. Good shot. Well, we're getting to the end of it now. It's just gone 2 o'clock and the birds are sort of just beginning to dry up a little bit now. I mean, we've had a fairly hectic, like, 2 or 3 hours. So we'll just give it another 10 minutes and then I'll slide off, get my truck, come back in, we'll start the process of picking everything up. That's the end of another day. We've had a fairly good day. Had a good pickup, a master total of 190, which at the start of the day wasn't looking like it was on the cards because of the weather that we've had to go through. It's a cold northeasterly wind with a blustery, snowy, haily type shower that's persisted for probably the first couple of hours in the morning. But once that cleared up and drifted away, the pigeons, they came on and they really wanted it. So we've had a good day. I mean, Alan here, I will compliment him on his shooting. Shot extremely well, had the only 3 bird of the day. Apparently my 2.5 bird doesn't count, but I'm still holding to it. What can I say? I can't stop saying, praising enough the Browning Maxes. It's nice to get it out of the cupboard again. It's been sat in there too long through the winter period when game shooting's been on, but it's been a great gun. And lastly, I'd like to thank Alan, because it's guys like Alan who put their hand in their pocket and contribute to charity events, and this charity today for Sean Whiters, who, as we know, was unfortunately lost both his legs in an accident, and it's people like Alan that contribute to the fundraising. And I just like to say, Alan, thanks very much for your donation.
I'd just like to thank you first of all for letting me use the Eleys today, first time I've ever used them, and I'll just reiterate what you said. These really do hit rather well. The other Eleys there are nice and smooth. Nothing wrong with the cartridges at all. Quite impressed, actually.
Well, you certainly shot some good birds, mate. You killed some good ones. And your 3-timer, your 3rd shot, was a shot to remember. And that was shooting these cartridges. So, they're a good cartridge. And I think these ones for long-range birds and for roost shooting will come into their own.
Yeah, ideal.
We'd just like to say, Alan, once again, thanks very much for your donation to the Sean Whiters Fund. Thanks for coming along. It's been a pleasure having you annoyed, mate.
All the best. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Geoff Garrod there making pigeon shooting look easy. And now it's a new special from IWA 2017.
This is the Shooting Show News. This week we report live from IWA 2017. Europe's leading trade show for the shooting industry, IWA is the big one for news and product launches. Fresh off the flight back from Germany, we've got a roundup of news from the show. The headline-grabbing product launch came from optical giant Swarovski, who released their smart DS scope along with the BTX spotter unit.
It is an honor for me to present the new DS rifle scope from Swarovski Optic. It is a rifle scope with a magnification range from 5 to 25 by 52 and has a parallax adjustment as well. The design is like a classic rifle scope design, but in the DS there is a lot more of digital and electronical intelligence. By pressing only one button, the DS measures the distance, the shooting angle, the temperature and the air pressure, and using these influence factors in combination with your individual ballistic data for calculating you the right aiming point and displaying you them immediately in your field of view. Another very unique feature of the DS is it is the first time that you have the possibility to connect a rifle scope with your smartphone and make all the settings very easy and very user-friendly via the smartphone. Download the DS Configurator app, which you can find in the App Store or in the Google Play Store. And with the DS Configurator, you can make all the ballistic settings similar to our ballistic program, very easy on the smartphone. And you also have the possibility to personalize your rifle scope via the app. The BTX is an additional model for our existing STX and ATX telescope line. So we have a modular telescope line where you can have a separate objective part and a separate ocular part. So if you have an existing ATX, for example, you also can use the BTX ocular model. So the great benefit of the BTX is you can really look with two eyes through a telescope. For observing over long distances and long time, this is a great help for you. We also have a forehead rest here on the BTX, which you can adjust on your preferred distance. And it is really awesome if you look with two eyes through a telescope and have such a big magnification.
On the other side of the same hall, Seiko and Tika were equally busy, releasing a host of new rifles, including the Seiko 85 Black Wolf.
We felt that people are more and more concentrating on the ergonomy of the rifle and ergonomy of how you're hunting and shooting. So we wanted to have our own version of super ergonomic hunting rifle. That's why we created the Seiko 85 Black Wolf, to introduce this nice vertical grip with some angles features. So every time when you take a shooting posture, your hand is ergonomically really relaxed, and you can really feel it when you pick this rifle up in the first place. By pressing these buttons in here, you can quickly adjust the ergonomics of the rear stock. On the front side, we have a flat base on the forend with two sling studs, so you can have your bipod and your sling at the same time. Especially with the modern scopes, when you have these scopes that have really narrow field of view and placement of the eye is really important, you need this adjustment. So this is a perfect rifle for these kind of high demand scopes where you can have these adjustments. And of course, when you can easily collapse everything, the packing length goes shorter. So it's much nicer to move around with the gun when you can bring everything down back to their normal settings. Other than that, actually, this rifle features a semi-heavy barrel profile. So you have the both benefit of a heavy barrel without having too much weight. We are aiming at a May-June production, so actually pretty soon.
And there was a new rifle from Franchi as well. Thought of as a shotgun manufacturer, the Italian company looks to be crossing the divide.
You know probably that for Franchi the main customer is the young hunter.
Yes.
And young hunter today wish to go hunting with rifle. It's more popular, more easy, you don't have to take care about the dog, and yeah. So much, much easier, and it is much closer to what hunting is today. So not large numbers of shots,
no.
But very pointed and ethic, let's say. Yeah. And this is match perfectly with Frankie philosophy. We wanted to give to our customers everything they need to go to have the best hunting day. So what we have decided is to follow exactly the strategy that we have created for the affinity, so the no frills strategy. So we put on our project, on our product, exactly all the necessary to go hunting without putting something that maybe can give more, beauty to the product, but without giving nothing in terms of performance. So for sure, nice wood, beautiful engraving, give something more to the shotguns that you need to show yourself, not to get better performance.
British companies were well represented abroad as ever. Chromatic showed us their personal use pigeon trap.
We've got this Chromatic pigeon machine, fantastic little machine that we brought out at the end of last year. The great thing about it is that it comes in a lovely little package, 50 clay capacity, throws about 65 metres, ideal, comes with a foot pedal release, so you can do a bit of shooting from home. And the great thing about it is that it's completely affordable at £335, which includes delivery in the UK and VAT, and that's our price for the UK. It's a little affordable machine, but we don't like to think that we've denied it any quality. The machine quality we tried to keep robust, and hope that it really looks after people when they use it, so that it will keep them going for a fair few years. But the nice thing about this machine really is that people can use it with their friends. Maybe they can get them introduced to shooting. They can have it out with the barbecue. Hopefully we'll have some nice weather this year in 2017. They can get it out while they're stoking up the coals on the barbecue. So that's really our aim.
And Rigby had a quintessentially Scottish launch for its Highland Stalker rifle.
We wanted to offer our customers an entry-level rifle in the smaller calibres, much the same as our big game rifle. And we decided to style it on those original Highland Stalking rifles that Rigby produced 100 years ago. Every shooting estate in Scotland would have had one of these. We've modernised one or two things, but we've kept it as traditional as we possibly can. There's five calibres to start with: 275 Rigby, also known as 7x57, 308, 3006, 8x57, and 9.3x62. There's always a place in your gun cabinet for a plastic rifle. I've got one, most people out there have got one, but there is a definite calling in the market for something a bit more traditional. I call this the Land Rover Defender, I suppose, of rifles. Whilst it is, you know, very traditional in its style, it functions and performs like any other rifle you'd buy on the market today. We've got some features on there like the hand finished checkering. We've got grade 5 wood, hand rubbed oil finish, traditional Rigby iron sights on there, which are exactly the same as those rifles that we produced 100 years ago. And the other thing that was also important to point out with it is we offer, and I think we're the only people in the UK that do it, a dedicated gentleman's and ladies' version of the rifle. So it's the same system. The ladies' rifle has a slightly different stock shape, shorter, with a different shape pad on there with a lady's toe. So we're trying to cater for both sides of the market.
From rifles to shotguns, Browning showed us something sumptuous from the top end of their range.
You've got two high grade and two lower grade, although even the lowest grade, which is this one, which is a B grade, is absolutely beautiful. The advantages of the higher grade guns is obviously you get the dummy three-piece forend here,
yep.
The pistol cap and the skeleton butt pad, which yep. just enhances the overall look of the gun. And you obviously get a higher grade of walnut as well. But the entry level to this product is about £11,000. So this is a semi-handmade gun, and with all that lovely engraving and woodwork for about £11,000.
So yeah, it's a lot of gun for £11,000.
It certainly is, yeah.
You know, for sure.
Yeah.
And I do believe there's been a lot of interest at the show.
We're actually sold out already for the year. We sold out in 24 hours.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So there is a bit of a wait on these now, yeah. But it's worth the wait. I think if you get your orders in with your dealer early on, you may get it for the game season.
And Cesar Guarini had something new too, a long-awaited extension to the Invictus line of guns.
This is called an Invictus M-Spec, so this is our flagship sporter, if you like. It's based on the standard Invictus action, so you've got all the interchangeable parts that you've had on every Invictus, but it's now the back action as well. So you've got, you've got fixed choke, you've got three-quarter full fixed choke, so it's a serious back hit. comes in a few different variations, so you can get an adjustable stock version if you wish. It's pretty much standard Invictus spec, but just ever slight changes. You've also got a 10-6mm tapered rib on here as well. Okay. Slightly different rib to the standard Invictus multi-choke. We find it helps draw your eye a little bit better as well. It's for the guys that basically, you know, want to shoot the serious stuff at the end of the day as well. You can shoot, if you want to take it out and shoot game, that you can do. So it wouldn't look out of place shooting game. And some people prefer a fixed choke as well. So it's Guarini's real first sort of attempt, if you like, at doing a fixed choke gun. I mean, it plays on everything that the Invictus did well. There is an ever so slightly changed trigger group in this. It's called a DPS 2 trigger, which is in the Invictus 5, which we launched last year. All of the internal components are hand polished, chrome-lined and hand polished, to give pretty much what we class as our Christmas ever trigger boots.
Last year we picked Oxus boots as our one to watch, and they prove they're not just a flash in the pan by releasing three new models this year.
This is a new model we call the Pioneer. We've brought this out specifically to appeal to someone who wants a really high quality boot at a very competitive price level. So extreme durability with 2mm thick rubber. Industry standard is around about 1.3 to 1.5. A lot of people use that. We use thicker rubber. Consequently, we can offer a 2-year warranty on this boot, and with a metal clamping buckle rather than a plastic buckle, which a lot of manufacturers have, again for durability and for ease of use. This particular model has a cotton liner, the Pioneer, and it retails at £140, so it's an extremely high quality boot, but at a competitive price level. This is a similar model, but it has a 3mm neoprene. So if you want a slightly warmer boot, if you like a neoprene boot, this is 3mm neoprene with a burgundy lining, keep you nice and warm. But again, same construction, very high quality, retailing at that sort of price level. So it's a very competitive boot. This is an interesting new model. I think this will appeal particularly to people who are looking for a boot they just want to pull on quickly, take off quickly, something that will go over trousers easily, and nothing too heavy, but still waterproof and very, very practical. So a very practical boot. Same construction, very comfortable sole, very high quality, leather trim around the top, two braces there that you can pull on and off very, very easily. You can actually get your fingers into those and pull them off very easily. Metal clamping buckle again. Now the advantage of that is that the strap goes all the way around, and when you pull that buckle and tighten it, it means that there's good support for the ankle, because a lot of problems with cheaper boots of this type is that they're not that easy to adjust at the top, and also they flap around and don't give very good ankle support, so they're not that comfortable for walking in the field in the day. That's a very, very practical boot for someone wearing maybe breeks as well, who doesn't want to wear a rubber boot, a high welly, or doesn't want to wear a leather boot. It's something nicely in between.
Finally, we saw another big step forward in the night vision world when we visited Pulsar.
This is the new generation of Digicide. It's called Digicide Ultra. It has certain peculiar features. It is based on the same platform, same electronics platform as our thermal imaging devices, and it shares some common features with that, such as the B-Pack, battery, integrated video recorder, and the Wi-Fi. But the most interesting features about the new Digicide Ultra generation is that they have HD sensor and they can produce a color image during the day. You get here picture-in-picture mode, you have two modes, day mode and night mode, certain colors, digital zoom, 15 zeroing distances, different zeroing profiles and different zeroing functions. The battery works for 10 hours, as I said, and it's quickly replaceable. You can record videos with that, and you can send videos live to YouTube with that. In all models of Digicide Ultra, the infrared illuminator is now detachable. You can basically unscrew this cap here and place one of the new infrared illuminators, like so. Screw it in, or if you want to use any of the auxiliary ones or any of additional ones, you can just place them here on the Weaver rail. Here we have a completely new range of digital night vision rifle scopes. They are called Sightline. The Sightline is rifle scope, digital night vision rifle scope, similar to Photon in sensor and similar to Digisight Ultra in electronics and features. We have integrated video recorder, Wi-Fi feature. It can also have the battery pack for 8-10 hours placed in. Has visible and invisible infrared illuminators, and there will be two models available with different objective lenses. The bigger one with 7-14 magnification, and the smaller one with 5-10 magnification. Also, if we talk about the power options, on this side right here, Sightline has a micro USB connection for charging the device with a power bank or for downloading files.
That's all we've got time for from IWA. That was the Shooting Show News.
Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching. Please like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. And if you're not a member of BASC, it's time to join now. BASC, looking after your sport, looking after you. This has been The Shooting Show.